Hello and welcome to this quick vulnerability update regarding the new iPhone vulnerability. Apple released a patch for a number of vulnerabilities, one including a vulnerability for iMessage, which allowed attackers to send specifically crafted iMessages to iPhones, which would completely brick them and would require them to be basically reset to their factory defaults. So in order to detect which of your iPhones are still out of date and need to be updated as soon as possible, we released a report that provides you an overview of all the mobile devices in your environment and their operating system version. So here we are within LandSweeper on our iPhone version report. As you can see, there's an overview of all the different iPhones we have. We only have three in our test environment here. We see the asset name, also what type of asset it is, the model, operating system, and then the next two columns are specifically interesting to us because they contain the operating system version and the patch status, which indicates whether your mobile device is up to date or still out of date. As you can see, this is also indicated by the color coding, so green lines will mean that that specific device is up to date and red ones means that they're out of date and need to be updated. So we'll take a look here at one of the devices. Once we end up on the LandSweeper asset page, we get an overview, kind of the summary information of this specific device. So we have the basic details like the user, what type of device it is, the operating system, and we get some more additional details like the storage details, we get serial number, subscriber carrier, etc. And if we head over to applications, we also get a complete list of all the applications that are installed and the specific version that is installed. So how do you get this information? All you need to do is head over to our website, download the trial, install it, and scan your network. Once the scan has completed, you'll end up on our dashboard. Now, if you head over to the asset tab, you'll see all the different types of assets that have already been scanned. Now, obviously, we want to add the report, so all you need to do is head over to the reports tab and then click on create new report. Next up, you can head over to our website and grab the vulnerability report from the report library. Once you've copied the report, simply remove the default report and paste in the vulnerability report instead. Then all you need to do is give a title and click on save and run. Once it's loaded, you'll end back up on the report we started this video with, giving you an overview of which devices in your environment might be vulnerable. Thank you for watching. If you want to try this out yourself, head over to landsweeper.com and start your own free trial. If you want to learn more about LandSweeper, take a look at the following videos.